All right, so now that we know what our landing page looks like on the front end to the customer, we want to take a look on the back end. Now, what I use for the website itself is WordPress. It's the most popular website platform system out there. And the designer that I'm using is called Elementor, but basically you can use whatever landing page designer that you want. Elementor is not necessary, but it's just the one that I use in particular. So we're going to go ahead into our edit Elementor page in order to edit the landing page. Now here we begin to dissect what's actually happening on the landing page. When someone lands on our page, if they don't have a particular keyword coming from Google, then it will say locksmith as default. And if we don't know their location, then we simply say your area. So if they're coming from, let's say, a VPN to hide their location, then it'll simply say your area. So once again, if we type in here, keyword equals, let's say, car unlock. So you can see 24/7 car unlock hotline in Buenos Aires. And then we go here, it's basically dynamically populated, and then hotline in display location, and then our default location. So if we want, we can change our location to location equals Hamilton, Ontario, right? So Hamilton, Ontario is in Canada, and that gets dynamically populated as well. So we have the dynamic keyword here and the dynamic location. And these are just two fields that you can type in, just a little text short code that you use here on the side. It's basically display underscore keyword and default equals the keywords. Then next we have the as of and then visitor underscore date and time. So currently, as of this tutorial, my time in the time zone that I'm visiting from is 6:32 p.m. or 1800 hours and 32 minutes. So that's another short code here. Once again, you simply type in a very simple little code here and it displays their time that they're visiting on. So this is amazing if you need a sense of urgency. Later on, I'll develop another one that has a countdown timer that you can implement as well. And on the countdown timer, you can say like, make it random that they have a limited time window to call in. And then whatever your proposition is to get them to call in or to complete the purchase or to do whatever it is you want to add a little bit of urgency. And then obviously you have the call buttons here. We continue down. Once again, dynamic location insertion. So display location equals your area. So what does it look like on the front end? Here we have Hamilton, Ontario, based on the location we have up here, and it gets populated here. So if we don't have a location, then it will try to find the location of the person. If it's not able to find their location, it'll say your area. If you type in the location in the address bar or the URL bar, it will basically show up here. And then when we go down, it'll show our map as well. So our map, this is what it looks like. It selects the map based on the location that it's able to determine from either what you put into the system, into the URL, or what it's able to detect of the user. So we continue down. And that's a very, very simple piece of code, Google underscore map. And in that case, you just get your little code from Google that allows you to use this system. And we continue downwards and how we help you, et cetera, et cetera. And then once again, display location and then location hotline and then everything else in between. So that's what it looks like on the back end. And one final thing, you can even see what it looks like on a mobile device. So here we have a little call to action button. So this is what's displayed when they're on a mobile phone. So I need service today and it's a little button that follows them around. You can implement that as well if you want. If you enjoyed this video, stay tuned for the next one to find out how we implement these short codes. And we're going to continue using our PPC basic plugin to implement everything. If you want, you can get access to this plugin right now. I do offer a trial. And as well, if you call in the number on here, you will actually hear a coupon code as well for the plugin. So call that number, get yourself a coupon code and check out the free trial and start testing the plugin for yourself. And also check out the rest of the videos to make sure you know how to use them. So let's continue and see you in the next video.